Now, here the poet tells us that though he don't know Africa, but still he has that love for the country. For example, we have a very good example now. Since India has crossed 30 millions of COVID cases, what's happened? The IPL match has been conducted in Dubai. And we are all Bangaloreans. Though we are native in some other state, for example, we come from Maharashtra, Andhra, Telangana, and so on. But still, if we stay in Bangalore, and we find that Bangalore is playing match with Chennai, whom will you support? Chennai. It's Bangalore only, right? Whatever it may be, you'll tell RCB, RCB, RCB. So same here happened with the poet also. He's telling that though I am not born there, but I have the love for my country or continent. That's Africa. Is this you, this black that is bent? Is this you, this back that is bent? Now, poet is asking the continent of Africa. Africa, tell me Africa. Is this you, this back that is bent? This means that why are the Africans treated so badly that we need to bow in front of the richer countries? This back that breaks under the weight of humiliation. The poet is telling that we all are ill-treated. We Africans are ill-treated. This back trembling with red scars. Yes, if we don't listen, when these Africans had become the slaves, and when they didn't listen to the work given by the colonialist, what happened to them? They were beaten red and blue. Yes? So here also what happened? When they didn't listen, they were beaten so badly that their backs were turning red with scars. So poet is telling, this back trembling with red scars, the back is filled with full of injury, and saying yes to the whip under the midday sun. What do you understand by yes to the whip under the midday sun? Beaten brutally in the hot sun. But a grave voice answers me, impetuous son, that tree young and strong, that tree there, in splendid loneliness amidst white and faded flowers, that is Africa, your Africa, that grows again patiently, obstinately, and its fruits gradually acquires the bitter taste of liberty. Here, the poet is teaching the Africans that do not lose. Even if you are treated very badly, one or the other day we will be freed from this slavery. Be strong enough. If we are strong, we can face everything. How many days can other colonialists come and ill-treat us? One or the other day, Africa will be freed. And he is also telling us that in splendid loneliness amidst white and faded flowers, in splendid, in the majestic loneliness, amidst white and faded flowers, one or the other day, there will be blooming flowers. That is Africa, your Africa, that grows again patiently, obstinately. So the poet is telling us that that is Africa, and this Africa one day will surely grow up with freedom. And its fruit gradually acquires the bitter taste of liberty. So poet is telling that the continent of Africa will surely be gifted with the fruit of freedom one day. So in this poem, we learn that freedom is very important for everybody. It doesn't matter you come from a rich or poor country. All that matters is freedom. And I hope you've understood the poem. Yes? Okay, thank you. I request you all to copy down the notes which will be sent through a link. You do not have to copy down the extra questions, but you need to learn them. Okay? Thank you.